Hello, Narnach here, welcome back to Path of Exile. Playing in the Flashback League as our Dominatrix Witch. And we still have the same modifiers as last time, so there's extra shrines, extra tormented spirits per area, monsters have onslaught, rogue exiles, there's extras of them. Of course, Perandus League is active and we have warbands. Not quite sure if there's going to be any in Daresso's dream though, because, well, Daresso would have to dream of the warbands, and we didn't encounter any with Calm either, so I don't think we're gonna find any of those here. We'll see. This game does like to throw curveballs, so it might happen. It just might. You never quite know. I am, of course, very happy with Zealot's Oath. We no longer have extra life regeneration, so Source of Chaos damage will hurt our life, but the trade-off is of course that our energy shield is now just regenerating itself, and that is a pretty darn potent thing. We lost a lot of stuff here, actually. Okay, one more zombie. Now we have our full group. Okay. I don't think the minions can deal with this. Eyepecker, yeah, you're rather annoying. Yes, gotcha. Turned you into a zombie, just for good riddance. Excellent. Time to move on. I've got my Zealot's Oath. Minions don't, of course. So the energy shield I grant them with my discipline aura. It only sticks as long as it sticks, and it helps a little bit, but the radius is just too short because this one is already falling out and they just keep going in and out, and generally they just lose their energy shield rather quickly. It's strictly speaking, it's not for them, it's for me. Okay, this is gonna be fun. We have our dominating blow and there's lots of enemies in a small confined space. We are probably gonna end up with a lot of minions. Fortify is going up. Let's see, teleport everybody here just so we can gang up on them. Always use strength of numbers to your advantage. Convocation is, it's an offensive spell, but it's also a defensive spell. There's a lot of utility to it and a lot of reasons to resummon your minions. I picked up something I shouldn't have. Verisite blade. It's not relevant for me. Did we overlook a chicken? We overlooked a chicken. Aye. Boom. Teleport of Doom. For them, not me. They're Doom. They're just really slow zombies just shambling about, completely not engaging with any opponents because they're just way too slow to keep up. That's also why teleporting them in every once in a while is a good thing. Yes, consuming some corpses here. That's pretty. 1, 2, 3. So that works. Bone offering. It actually lasts for about 5 seconds then, rather than 2. Or however short it lasts by default. Oh, interesting. Yes, go be possessed. Excellent. There's a ghost possessed thing here. Yes, I think. A ghost possessed rare. Yes, you. If I manage to convert you, then I will have a ghost possessed thing on my side for a while. Which is rather potent. Not liking how hyperactive these things are. They all have hit and run tactics, makes it really hard to actually finish them off. There's like half a dozen that have like 5% health remaining. Get back here, cowards! Get back here and fight! Yes. Oh well, one person's coward is another person's strategic withdrawal. I will admit that's completely up to interpretation by whoever is doing the shouting. Okay, this is going slightly belly up. Let's regroup a little bit. So calling it regrouping here. There you go. Okay, let's go back in. Full group. Got our spectre up. Just keep summoning. If it was easier to get a longer change on skills, like to experiment with something like a detonate dead on melee kill. That could be fun. Ah, okay. So they're under a bubble. That explains why they are just being so annoying to deal with. 4 and 5 zombies. I said 5 zombies. Teleport everybody back. And then we walk in. And I really have to go under the bubble. Or just kill enough outside of the bubble. But the bubble protects. The bubble is annoying. Because it's powerful. Well, annoying is... No, it's just a tricky thing to deal with. Especially if you don't notice it. Or just don't consciously process that you actually have to go in order to hit things. It might take a while and you might lose all your minions as a result. Okay, I think we got everything. This was a dead end. Not often that I have to backtrack a lot in this level. Most of the time I am lucky with how I choose to navigate. Ah, higher level stone golem, which means more energy shield regen and thus better tanking capabilities. How much is it up to now? It was 50, it's now 53. So extra 3 points. Still, it's 3 points of regen I did not have before. 1 and 2 and bone offering. Bone offering, of course, it gives a pretty good block chance to all your minions, and when they block, they gain life. So it's a very good way to both prevent them from taking damage, but also to just restore their life while they do it. Parkour, and there is a rogue exile here. We'll have your hide. Yeah. Parkour will not have anything. Not even his own hide, if I'll have my say. Parkour will have your hide. I do have to be a bit cautious here. There's a rogue exile. Iron Dark Shroud. Yes, just take you out first. Okay. They are doing a lot of damage. I'm losing minions left and right. Actually, it's not that bad. Hey, bone offering. Let's give everybody some tankiness. Okay. All this burning is causing some frame rate issues, but that can't be helped. Now we go for Baku, and everything that stands around is just going to get dominated. So please get around. Get around, everybody.
Little piggy.
What? Little piggy? I'm not a piggy. You're the piggy. You're a dead piggy. That's what you are. Well, it was interesting. But energy shield with Zealot's Oath, it is definitely very useful. It definitely kept up for a large part of the fight. 1, 2. Anything interesting among this? No, not really, actually. Okay, let's go. Grand Arena of Theopolis. So it's about 10 minutes and we are halfway through the first area. might actually have a full episode dedicated to Daresso as well. It's been a while. It's refreshing. Just to have a slower paced build instead of one of the blitzy builds that I've been stumbling onto for the last couple of playthroughs. Let's see, this is it's just too low level. Even though the resistances on these are pretty solid, but the energy shield is just too little. Level 96 died. That's also unfortunate. Well, it's the final stretch of the league, so yeah, people are pushing, seeing if they can get slightly further on the ladder, things like that. Then people are gonna die. Sad, but part of the race. 96 in 2 weeks. That's an achievement. That's dedication. There's people with a lot more Path of Exile playtime available than I have. That's for sure. Well, everybody has something. I have issues just staying focused too much on the same thing for long stretches, so just doing like 2, 3, 4 different game series at the same time on the channel. It is really good for mixing things up, and it does keep all the games that I play interesting for a lot longer than they otherwise would be, which definitely has a value. Also, I think we have a dead end arena, because there's supposed to be a gate here and there's not, so let's go back. And I think we're losing allies left and right. Boom, 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 boom. Next. Kadiro is just standing in here as if there's nothing dangerous, nothing scary, nothing to worry about. Let's summon a couple of corpses and then we cast our bone offering. I have to say, I'm getting slightly better at keeping our zombies alive. The trick is just to completely drop all the corpses of Desecrate on the floor, just cast it 3 times in a row, and then Bone Offering. That gives you quite a lot of sustainability. This is a tough bugger. So the fact that he runs away all the time does not help at all. Wow, that was interesting glitching, even though that's not supposed to happen. I'm playing this in lockstep mode, I'm not supposed to glitch. Yeah, there's no weird latency or anything going on with the connection. Okay. We'll just go with it. Let's see, let's resummon the spectres. This is a random mobs, or yeah, let's just go for random mobs. Ooh, a crystal range caster, that's pretty good. It's like having an ice golem without actually having an ice golem. 1, 2 block. Okay, Kadiro, what do you offer? Crimson Jewel. Tempting, but no thanks. I need my points for uniques. So I can't waste them on rare jewels. Kadiro. Okay, offering. Okay, slowly starting to turn things. Okay, slow burn, life regen. Of course, I've got a slow burn regen, and I've got a faster insta heal, just to mix things up. It's definitely useful because now I'm currently tanking again on my energy shield. So then you can just, you can afford to regenerate on just a slow burn potion. So interestingly, I can't max my life right now. Even while drinking potions, and I'm not actively degenerating as far as I am aware. I wonder why that is. Also, we lost a zombie and our spectre. So let's reclaim those. Well, this is where actually one of the interesting bits is compared to the ringleader dominator. The ringleader, which is just a dominating blow build without actual summons. The fact that you got the zombies and the specters and you got the desecrate to resummon them at any time, basically, means that in a fight like the Daresso fight, you will actually be able to summon minions all the time. Rather than maybe entering with some dominated minions for the first wave, but the last three quarters of life of Daresso, you need to do it without actual any minions on the ringleader, for example. And here you can use that pause to resummon your minions as needed. That's also an interesting change of pace. So just do an offering. Teleport everybody in just to centralize our power a little bit. So what the heck is happening here? Once we got things killed, let's have a quick look at my... it doesn't say here. I see, lockstep. So I should be in sync with the server and there should not be any weird glitching and teleporting and rubber banding and things like that. Okay, we'll go with it. So we got quick recovery, we got Zealot's Oath. So then the question is going to be Puppet Master or Herd the Flock. This just increases all the minions alive by 36%. This gives them extra health regen. So they're both useful. I think for now we're just going to go with the bigger buffer. And then after that we just finish it up by giving them more regen as well. Also, this is going to be some travel points to get to, so it's slightly more efficient to go with the flow we got now. Let's summon some corpses underneath your feet and then explode them. Foul leisure. Excellent. You are now one of my minions. And everybody, please teleport. And you, one. Join up. Join up. Yes, yes. Thank you. Oh, and there's something that's ghost possessed. We have to kill it. I keep forgetting about the ghosts. Life is short, dear. Okay, fair enough. Oh, two chests, might as well open those. And now we move on. Everybody teleport over here, just cause to not have you distracted by the previous fight. They'll wander over here anyway. Okay, okay. Next fight is going to be the one with the unique bosses. We'll just teleport in. Hello there, parkour wannabe. So something is inflicting some chaos damage. I'm just completely focusing on this whirlwinder because he is the most annoying one because he's just good at dealing with my group. Hello there, Mevian. You're also dying rather quickly. Excellent. One, two, and three. We got all our pets again. This was rather trivial. And we still have a unique to kill, I believe. Otherwise, this door would open. Question then becomes, where is the unique and why haven't you shown yourself? Get out here, coward! I challenge you! Okay, teleport everybody in, so things will gather. Get around, please, get around. This side, I don't think there's any more uniques, or is there maybe a ghost in the corner that counts as a unique that needs to be killed before we can move on? Might as well, might be. I did lose a ghost. Ah, you! Rudiaris Felix. And I think we got him. Most excellent, most excellent. And the doors are open. My expectation actually is proving to be correct. It is a full episode just to clear out Daresso's lair. That's not happened to me in quite a while. Most of the time you just blitz through in 10 minutes. But I definitely do notice that the dynamic of the game has changed now that I have the Zealot's Oath. I really feel sturdier. Hello there, Agustina Solaria. It also means I'm no longer as reliant on using the minions to tank for me as I was before. Okay, let's not click. I'm just holding my attack here, but not actually clicking. Because we're standing next to the Ring of Blades. I really don't want to enter there. Unintentional. Click, click. Just refresh all the pets. Teleport them in. And Onyx Amulet. No, okay. Ring of Blades, Daresso. Of course, Dominating Blow for damage. So, and less mana use, that's also an important thing. Summoning the golems and specters. Well, wondering if I maybe should ignore the pets here and just go for the kill. Since I'm spending a lot of time just summoning pets here, with his AoEs, he does do a lot of damage to the pets. And I can actually tank it if I just have the golem up. The golem is my regen in this case, and for the rest I can just tank through a lot of the attacks. Well, I was gonna say I can tank through. The other hand, doesn't cost all that much. Okay, we now have some block for our pets, that is gonna help. One, two, block. And we take him down. And is he? Oh, I thought he was down, but he needs to get hit once or twice more. Yeah, like that. Okay. One, two. One, two. If he's focusing on the pets, it's pretty good, actually. I don't take as much damage. Everybody got some block, love. And we just fight. You murder love. Yeah. You're no sovereign. He really does have issues dealing with the regen if there are pets around, because he's just dividing his attention too much then. If I'm alone, I become a bit more fragile. On the other hand, you are also rather fragile. It's interesting. Sometimes you focus too much on your own weakness rather than on his weakness, while it's easier to just give him a couple more punches to take him out instead of retreating and resummoning your corpses or your zombies. But it's one of those habits that, in general, it is a better idea to just make a strategic withdrawal and then come back in force, even if you only need to take out 1% of the boss, if you can do it from a position of strength and confidence, rather than being nearly dead yourself and just being in a last-ditch brawling effort with your opponent, and just whoever lands the first blow is going to win. That's not a position you want to be in, because that's the kind of Russian roulette gaming. Eventually you are going to lose, and if you're playing hardcore, that's not a fun thing to do. Walnut Spirit Shield. That's almost as much energy shield as we have. Yeah, might have a look at it. But either way, that was Daresso. So I'm going to thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.